Do you want to know what is BIOS in computers and how does it work? Then you are at the right place as we have the solutions for you to fix this issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. BIOS is short for Basic Input-Output System. It is much more than the name suggests. BIOS controls input and output systems. However, the BIOS does much more, and it is only possible for any operating system to continue with a proper BIOS in place. In this video, we will explain what BIOS is in computers. Let's get started. What is BIOS? BIOS has been in our computers since the days of DOS, disk operating system, even before the structured DOS created by Microsoft. It is one of the most important components of the computer, though it does not take credit for regularly appearing on your screen. BIOS is firmware stored on a chip on the part of the computer motherboard. It is a set of instructions that run to help load the operating system. Your OS would fail to load if not for the BIOS. When you turn on the computer, BIOS instructions are initiated. These instructions make it check your computer's RAM and the processor for faults. It enumerates the RAM by checking each compartment to see if they all work. After checking out RAM and processor, it checks for other devices attached to the computer. It detects all the peripherals including the keyboard and mouse and then checks for the boot options. Boot options are checked in the sequence configured in your BIOS. Boot from CD-ROM, boot from hard drive, boot from LAN, etc. It checks for device bootstraps in the order in which you or the machine vendor configured the BIOS. It passes the reins of the computer to the operating system by loading the essential parts of the OS into the random access memory, RAM, reserved for the OS after the bootstrap is located. This is a partial list of BIOS functions. It also checks up CMOS and other chips to set up the computer's date and time and load the device drivers into the memory. It checks and uploads input and output interrupt signals to the RAM so the operating system knows what is happening. If a user presses a key, an interrupt request is created and passed on to the BIOS, which sends it to the operating system. The operating system then decides what action to take according to how it is programmed. The operating system cannot work without BIOS because the former resides on a hard disk or a removable disk. The BIOS loads the drivers for the hard disks and removable disk drives so that they are functional. It then loads the primary portions of the operating system, such as the MBR, GPT, FAT, etc., into memory so that the operating system can continue loading itself. Making changes to BIOS. It is easy to make changes to BIOS when required. The most common change people make in BIOS is to change the boot order. While the computer is booting, press the Del key on your keyboard to enter BIOS. From there, you can see different options grouped under different headers. Use the tab and arrow keys to navigate. Sometimes the page up and page down keys are required to change the values of essential items. When you are done, press F10 to save changes and exit. The options are displayed on the right or bottom of the screen so that you know what keys to press for saving or discarding changes. The options also specify what keys to use for changing values. How to update BIOS? As the computer scenario changes, new devices are introduced. To make a computer work with these devices, the BIOS has to be upgraded. If your operating system fails to detect a new peripheral, it is possible because the BIOS doesn't know how to handle it. If you face any such issues, checking if any BIOS updates are available might be a good idea. You have to check the BIOS version first. To do this, follow this guide. You can do this by entering BIOS when booting and pressing Del. Once you have the version of your computer BIOS, update it. You can follow this guide to learn more. You can also visit your computer manufacturer's website to see if an updated version of BIOS is available. If there is, download it and run it. The process generally involves wiping off all the previous information on the BIOS chip and rewriting it with the new information. Make sure you have a proper backup power while upgrading the BIOS. If the computer turns off during the process, the BIOS may be corrupted and you will need a technician to fix it. Your boot CD or DVD may or may not help, depending upon how the BIOS stands after a power cut or a sudden system turn off while rewriting the BIOS. How to flash BIOS without a CPU and RAM? You can also update your BIOS to the latest version by flashing it without a CPU and RAM. This method is helpful if your computer is not booting after upgrading your CPU and RAM. Some motherboards have a dedicated button to flash the BIOS. If your motherboard has such a button, you can flash it. Flashing the BIOS without a CPU or RAM is easy. First, download the latest version of your BIOS from the official website of your computer manufacturer. Copy the file in the required format to your USB flash drive. The file system of the USB flash drive should be FAT32. Turn on the power supply and plug the USB flash drive into the required USB port. Press the dedicated button to start the BIOS flashing process. This process will take up to 10 minutes. We suggest you refer to your user manual for the exact process of flashing your BIOS. If your computer works properly, you do not need to update or flash your BIOS. Should you wish to, we recommend that you do not try to update your BIOS yourself, but instead take it to a computer technician who may be better equipped. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.